Wait, 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 no, you have to, I didn't start it.
Sorry.
Okay, now.
Yes, this is it.
Okay, hi everybody. This is my third video blog. This is your first. This is my friend Bernard. Bernard and I have eaten many, many, many dinners together, but he's never cooked me dinner, so. This dinner that he's gonna make, how did you describe it to me?
It's a carbonara, which is the easiest of all of the dishes that I have ever seen made, and yet it's also one of the delicious, and that's why I love making it, the simplicity of it all.
And also, why I thought that this video blog would be funny was because he told me that this was a guaranteed to get you laid dinner. So if you're ever making dinner
it is.
For somebody and you really just like them a lot and want to show them how much you like them physically.
Yes. Sadly, I've never actually made this for a girl except for you.
And that's not going to happen. So. Oh, it's so sad.
Wow. Okay. So I want to show you the ingredients we're going to be using today. We have bacon, which this is pork belly specifically, but bacon and pancetta, you can use one or the other, or both, which we're doing. And then we have Parmesan Reggiano, so it's a hard raw milk cheese, the specific one from Italy. You want a black pepper, which we have here from Daniel DeLuca.
That was a birthday present from, or birthday, Christmas, Jesus' birthday, from Bernard.
And this is a
along with grater. That grater, or the grinder that he got me, which is just lovely.
This is the cheese grater we're going to be using. Two eggs. Just so you know, the big question is carbonara. There is no cream in a carbonara. It's really great carbonara. It doesn't come with any cream. You're going to think after it's over that there is cream involved, and yet, because it's so creamy, it's so creamy, but it's all because of the egg and the cheese. So, we're gonna get it going.
Yeah.
Alright.
I was going to make a really lewd joke about how, well, if this is a really good date, then there will be cream later in the evening, but I just made that joke. Look at that. The people love my humor.
It's a pork belly, and I just want to point out to everybody, this is the skin of the actual pig, and you can see it, this is the little guy's hair up here. It's been, like, kind of shaved off, but it's still definitely there. And this is particularly gross. This is like a wart or something. It's a nodule, right, you said?
I feel like a nodule, a nubbin.
A nubbin or a nodule. It could be a third nipple, for all we know.
Wouldn't it be closer to the other nipple?
Oh my god, I think it is the third nipple. No, it's close to the... It's
so
on the
wrong.
Belly! It's on the belly!
Oh my god. It might be... Yes, true.
It's not a third nipple. It's like a 15th nipple on a pig. Okay, go.
Okay, so now I had Steph cut all of the pancetta and bacon.
That's a lot of pancetta and bacon for two people.
This.
My largest plate.
Lardon. What's going to end up happening is we're going to cook this. And while we're cooking that, I've shaved, as you can see, all that cheese into this bowl. And we're going to crack two eggs into it.
Into the cheese?
Into the cheese. And
oh
we're going to bind it together.
No way, really?
Yes, yes.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, so while that's cooking, that's what's going to happen. And then we'll go from there.
That's crazy.
And then we're going to pour in some cheese. Okay, now here's the trick to a great carbonara is the cheese, the amount of cheese you're putting in.
I think the amount is probably lots, right?
Yeah, you're putting in more than you think would be correct. So let's, you put in a little bit, okay?
How much would you say that is for the people? Like a cup?
Less than a cup at this point. You're
okay.
Just trying to bind it together.
I'm going
to
say it's about a half.
See, but it's too eggy now. You see how it's too
oh,
eggy?
Oh, yeah, cheese.
It's far too eggy,
yeah,
right?
Wait.
So we're going to continue to add more cheese. Also, you want to use real cheese, like cheese that you grated yourself, as opposed to...
Are you telling the people not to use craft Parmesan?
You can! I just don't think you're going to have as good a...
You can! Angels will cry.
So, you keep on doing it. Keep in mind, if you want it more eggy, some people like it really eggy, you can, you know... So now,
let's see.
We're getting to that place now. See, it's cooked down.
Looks delicious!
It's coloring up. To that great,
great
color. Okay, and then what's going to happen is, here are the elements that are going to happen.
The elements,
okay, so
yes.
We're going to put the pasta in, we're going to cook the pasta.
Mm-hmm.
At this point, we'll take the bacon off, and we will dry out all the fat we can.
On that thing right over there with the pepper on it that I was testing my new grinder.
And then what's going to happen is, after the pasta's drained, after being cooked, about 10 minutes, 4 minutes in, we're going to drain it and then pour in the egg cheese mixture, which will then...
This is so intense, I feel like I'm doing surgery here right
okay,
now.
So, okay, so, drain the pasta water.
Yes.
That's just the pasta. Now we're going to do the egg mixture, which will... As you can see, it's like...
It's pretty goopy.
Now keep in mind it's hot, okay, so it'll melt all this cheese and egg, it'll cook the egg, so you'll see this egg mixture, it's going to be very, you can see it's already starting to cream up, and there's no cream!
No, not yet!
Oh my god.
Whoa, that's insane!
All of that is just egg and cheese. There's no cream, and yet it looks like there is cream, right?
It does.
It looks like there's cream. Okay, now.
Now.
We get the bacon.
Bacon there.
We're gonna dump all this bacon in. Bacon and pancetta. Look at that. I mean, it's just cheese.
Yeah, yeah.
And egg.
Yeah, oh my god, this is gonna be so good.
Okay.
I'd have to just turn the camera off because I'm just gonna point the camera at this the rest of the time and, yeah.
Alright, done.
Okay. Okay, Bernard said that he wanted to get this on camera, so I'm gonna try the best, most excellent bite in the world. It's really good. Yeah. Yeah, it's really good. It's like...
What's it like, Steph? Tell us.
It's like really good, really cheesy, like macaroni and cheese, kind of, but better, because it has really big hunks of bacon in it and a lot of pepper. It's really good. It's really good. Yeah, it's better than I thought it would be.
Oh. Bernard and I just saw ourselves pop up on the screen and we're like, wow, we just look like we just ate a lot of food.
We had two bowls of pasta.
Each.
It's a lot of food, I'll be honest with you, but it's going to be worthwhile tomorrow morning when Steph wakes and has
a little bit of pasta. There's really not that much left.
It's all pork and bacon.
It's all bacon.
It's all pork and bacon, so successful.
It was very successful.
Thank you, Steph, for letting me cook.
Thank you, Bernard, of course. Thank you for coming home. This has been good. I think that people will like this.
Okay, good. Okay. I do want to say hi to my mom. Hi, Mom.
Oh, hi, Mom. My mom won't watch. Your mom is going to watch this?
Sure. We'll
talk about sex. My mom is not going to watch this.
Mom's not going to watch it?
No, not this one.
Really?
No.
Okay.
No. Probably not. As much as she likes you, I don't think she wants to hear you talk.
Well, but that's you. I didn't bring it up at all.
That reflects poorly on me.
I was cute and adorable the entire time.
As was I, but I do talk about a few dirty things. I'm not gonna let my mom watch this. Gosh.
I'm so saying it's your mom. I'm saying your sister will send it to your mom.
You can send it to my sister won't show it to my mom.